Hello and welcome back to the desktop where all the magic happens. My name is Paul the Abominable Llama, and today we're going to be playing some Wolf Among Us. Last time we left off, we had just finished up episode 4 in Jeep's clothing, and we had just sat down to have a conversation with the, the Crooked Man. So this appears to be the last episode, so it's either this one you're watching right now is either the finale or the one right after it. But let's jump straight into it. It's been quite a wild ride for this game. In general, it's... Oh, man.
Your eyes and the teeth? You're not really supposed to do that, are you?
It's like letting us know what happened throughout the last four episodes.
Not if I can avoid it.
Oh no, that was hard to look at. Oh. Oh man, I remember when that happened.
Lily.
Damn, dude.
Do you even give a shit about us? The strays?
Yeah, dude.
That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it?
We're destroying the tree.
I said no to that.
We're not burning the tree, Snow.
Hey, you're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you?
Yeah, man, I am.
The rules are the rules. I don't get to make them, I just enforce them.
Bullshit.
Don't give me that shit, Colin. Does she have, like, silver bullets or something?
Oh, God, Bigby!
This time's no joke. Eat as many metal shillings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart. And the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue.
Yeah, man.
Bigby, thanks, wait. Doc. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial.
I'm not sure if I can actually make that happen,
though.
Why don't
you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
Yeah, we do. You douche nozzle. Let's get into it, guys. Ah, man. Ooh. This is gonna be good. I'm expecting some street justice, but, I mean, who knows? This game has been a wild ride start to finish, and we haven't finished it quite yet. Ugh. Direction, David Bogan. Environment, Kim Lyons. Alright, episode 5, Cry Wolf.
You've come a long way.
Yeah, I have.
You must be tired.
Crooked Man's lair, night time.
And if my envoys are correct, you haven't had a lot of rest recently.
That is correct. I didn't come here to fight.
Relax for a moment, will you? Something to eat. Vivian makes it very nice. Very... It's elegant. Really, a carpaccio.
I'm here for one reason.
Sirloin.
I'm here for
I need to talk, bro.
It's not to eat your fucking food.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, really.
What do you think you're doing?
He's gonna...
Mr. Wolf is our guest, and I have every intention of cooperating.
Ooh, so this might be interesting.
Sit down, Jersey.
Crooked Man's got him on a leash. Dang.
Well, Sheriff, for the sake of transparency...
Who is he? Who is he supposed to be?
It would help settle everyone's nerves, I think.
You tried to kill
what
me.
What happened at the Pudding and Pine? You and your goons tried to kill me.
I'm truly sorry for that whole debacle. It was not my intention to put you all this white in this danger. My wish was merely to take Crane, Sheriff. And as soon as the assignment grew out of control, I put a stop to it. I know that doesn't change what happened to you. And I can only offer my sincerest apologies.
Crane wasn't yours to take.
I apologize if I overstep my bounds. Won't happen again. And I hope you believe me when I say, Sheriff, that I sincerely mean to make it up to you. The recent murders that have gotten such attention as of late, I don't relish telling you that they were perpetrated by an employee of mine. It's a very unfortunate bit of business, but I promise you that the matter will be dealt with internally. I just want to set an issue for you and to assure you that it's...
Who did it?
An unfortunate bit of business. You're going to tell me right now who killed him.
Sheriff, I have complete respect for you and your job. I hope you know that. But I simply can't divulge that information.
Buddy, if you want to cooperate...
You really shouldn't worry yourself. As I said... I've got this under control.
No, but Crooked Man...
I'm gonna deal with it right now.
Yeah, right. What do you think this is? Some kind of negotiation?
I let you live, bro.
The man said he'd take care of it. So why don't you take the hint and get out?
I'm the law here, not you. Now tell me who did it.
I mean, why you can't you just tell me?
I'm scared of you.
I let you live.
That's enough.
I was hoping it would.
I let him live.
But, in the interest of preserving our alliance, you have to know who's Georgie. However, like I said, I'd be handling the matter if you don't mind.
Georgie, you got what you wanted. Just
sit down now.
I'm so, like, mixed up right now.
I killed him, so what?
Why'd
you do it? Why kill them? Does it matter?
Yeah, it does matter.
The fact is, George here misinterpreted one of my instructions.
Misinterpreted?
And I want to make things right. So, let's work something out.
What's there to work out? I'm protected, aren't I?
Your protection has limits, and I think you've far exceeded yours. But you could murder someone in cold blood like that.
I feel like he's...
And then attempt to blame me for it. You will be silent while we discuss what to do with you.
This is right, bollocks, sis.
What are you going to tell me? You're
just going to let him do this.
Well, I mean, why didn't you answer my question?
So what do you say, Sheriff? Can we discuss terms? You can have Georgie. Consider it a gift. Ensuring our continued cooperation.
What the hell?
Take this fucker. Take all of them. I didn't fucking start this.
I'll take both of you.
I'll be taking both of you. You're not taking me, you fucking punts. What the fuck is this shit? You said you'd cover for us.
For minor infractions, not murder.
Just go with them, Georgie. You're gonna sink us all.
Oh, wow.
What's wrong with you people? You're really gonna sell him out just like
you
that?
You can't give a fuck if I'm the one... Who the shit do you think you fuckers are?
Get the fuck out of here!
I do apologize, Sheriff, but I think it's best if you leave now.
There's no way I'm going with him! Are you kidding me?
Things are about to get unpleasant, and I would rather you weren't here to watch.
You can go join that whore at the bottom of the lake for all I give a shit, but he's not taking me anywhere.
This is so confusing.
Before I let that shit happen.
I told you I'm taking you in.
What the fuck? You're gonna make sure we all go down this shitter with you?
Well, we're grabbing the Crooked Man.
I'm out of patience, Crooked Man. I don't have time to fuck around here.
This could have gone so well. But you just had to complicate things.
Yeah, I did. I did.
To say the truth, I've never been a very good mediator. Why negotiate when you can just decide?
What's up, Mary?
Did I miss anything good?
Yeah, you did. You missed a lot.
Well, look at you all fixed up.
I figured as much. I honestly did figure this was gonna happen. Oh, well... Come here, ha! Stop it, guys. What the fuck?
You're done, Wolf!
Come on, we're pretty much done here.
Go for him. Come on. You stabbed Tweedledee. Or dumb. Another button masher. Come on. Put it right in his stomach. Damn, dude. Oh my Jeebus. Another ace masher. Ha, to the left. Take it back now, y'all. One hop this time. Huh. Left foot, left stomp. Right foot, left stomp. Hands on your knees. Hands on your knees. Tweedle dick. Going after him. We didn't even have to go full wolf for this.
Come on, George. Oh, shit.
I know.
You assholes fucking attacked me. I'm after your dumbasses. Let's go. Come on. Shimona. Tell me. You're not going nowhere. Not going anywhere. What is going on here? I don't know what's going on. Whoop, left. What are we doing now? We're gonna swish up. Left. Right. Ah, oh, fuck me. Keep going. Did we lose him now because of that? That fucking blows. Smashing. Oh man. This is crazy shit, man. Dude, this is fucking intense. Up. Oh, I did it late. I gotta do it at the right time. Keeping up with things. Up. Oops-a-daisy. Keep going. On the car.
Fuck! What was that?
Your mom. Your worst nightmare. Left, right. Smash the window, I guess. Other window. Man, pressing these buttons is so difficult. Like, really, man? Piece of shit. We should have jumped onto the limousine. I didn't know Crooked Man was in a limousine. I didn't even realize that. Oh, yeah?
Are you sure?
Do it! Not moving. Keep going!
I wanted to kind of stay there and just flip him over, but whatever.
Come on.
Well, we've got some clothes hanging around for us. And it's conveniently almost the same exact stuff we've always been wearing. Let's look at the things. Well, can't walk back there. Let's open the door. He attacked me first. I mean, not having none of that. This house of straw, achievement unlocked. Interesting stuff's going on.
We can't stay here.
Hang on, I need a minute.
Okay. Listen, we're gonna listen.
Can you stand up? It's okay. Take your time. Slowly.
Oh, it's no fucking use. No way I'm walking out of here.
How did this happen, Georgie? How did it get this?
Take a peek.
Fuck.
Let's walk in. Piece of shit. You killed those girls. Who's behind all of it? Why did you do it?
Hello, Bigby.
Well, at least you greeted me this time. I swear to God.
But of course, you're too much of an idiot to see that. Or maybe you just like me too much to let me go.
I'm gonna be quiet.
That it, Sheriff. I had to say goodbyes first.
I don't want to do anything to you. I already stabbed you. That's enough.
Please, Sheriff. Haven't you done enough? Look at him. He's dying.
Vivian,
why?
You can't seriously want to protect this guy. You know what he did.
I'm not going anywhere. It isn't his fault.
He's a murderer. Faith and Lily, he's the reason they're dead.
Look, I know he made a few mistakes. We all have.
What? He made sure they couldn't talk with those damn ribbons, and then he killed them. You're wearing one yourself. Doesn't that bother you even a little, knowing that man murdered...
Of course it does. Those girls...
So it's all my fucking fault, then. You're gonna throw it to the fucking wolf, too? You know I didn't have a goddamn choice. What the fuck?
Okay, so what is his choice? What is his choice?
You can't fucking blame me for that.
Why did you do it, you piece of shit?
If it's not your fault, then what the fuck happened?
You better start talking.
Faith and the others tried to pull a run on us. And as you can imagine, the crooked man wasn't too thrilled. But of course, the big boss didn't want to get his fucking hands dirty. So he told me to take care of it. You think I don't know what that means? Either I do what he says or I'm the one getting dealt with. So I fucking killed him. And I'd do it again. Cause it's not my fault. The crooked man gave the order. He told me to kill them. And then he fucking sold me out.
You're still the one who pulled the trigger. Nobody held your hand and made you go through with it.
Fine. Believe what you want. I can tell you've made up your mind. Doesn't matter if it's fucking true or not.
Yeah. Yeah, I did make up my mind.
Go ahead and kill me then.
But I'm not gonna kill him.
Lily or Faith. It won't free your friend Narissa. And I'm just the sap taking the fall for the whole thing.
No, you told me what I needed to know.
It must be so easy being you. Just come in here and blame me for all this shit. Job's done, right? George is the bad guy. It's all his fucking fault.
No. No, it's not. It's not only your fault.
What was I supposed to do? You don't know what it's like, Bigby.
Stop whining.
How could you know? At the end of the day, you're just like him.
Stop whining.
Stop complaining and take responsibility for what you did. You murdered Faith and Lily. You put those fucking ribbons around their necks. You had the power to let him go, but you chose not to.
You don't know what the fuck you're talking about. If I freed them...
would they die anyway?
What would you have me do? Kill her?
Georgie, don't.
It was them or Vivian. So you tell me, if freeing Lily meant she had to die... you still think I had a fucking choice?
What the fuck are you talking about?
This is the original. The girl with the ribbon. I'm sure you've heard the stories. Couldn't take it off. Couldn't talk about it. She used her little purple ribbon to make more of them. To keep our girls quiet. To ensure absolute discretion.
I promised you wouldn't.
All that magic is connected to this little thing. You remove hers, and the spell's broken. They're all free. But you know what happens to her? The same thing that happened to Faith. So don't you come in here and tell me I fucked up.
What the hell, Georgie? We were supposed to look out for each other. I trusted you.
You can't fucking blame me.
You've been helping him.
You're not innocent here either.
I know that.
I don't even know what to say. I'm gonna be quiet.
You sold me out.
Welcome to the club, then.
You have to understand.
This is tough.
Nobody was supposed to die. When we built this place, it was just a stupid idea. A gimmick. Discretion is our guarantee. That's how it started, anyway. This was supposed to be our place. We were going to be in charge for once, and nobody would try to control us or use us. That was the point. And the crooked man showed up, and everything just turned to shit.
Okay, so...
so, do you get it now? Why I couldn't just...
Yeah, I do, but stop giving me shit.
If you still think it's so fucking simple, then you do it. Go right ahead.
So we gotta find the fucking crooked man.
What are you doing?
Break the
a spell.
I won't kill her, pull her ribbon. We'll find another way. We'll find another way.
Sometimes all your options are shit.
We'll find another way. She doesn't have to die. Maybe the witches can...
Don't talk about me like I'm not even here. Please. You think this is hard for you? My life is such a fucking burden on your conscience. Don't I get a say?
Yeah, you do.
Life. Like it was either of yours to give up in the first place.
Of course you do.
You're right. It's your life.
Do you want to die?
Wait.
I'm sick of everyone thinking that they can just do what they want.
So you're gonna take your own life?
I thought it would be.
Because that's not a solution.
But it's all the fucking
stuff. Vivian, I didn't mean.
Do you think I wanted to be this person? What I did to Faith and Lily, to all of them.
Vivian, wait.
Oh jeez.
Every day I have to look Gwen and Hans in the eye and pretend I don't care. I have to forget what I've done to them. What I took away from them. I look at Larissa.
Oh my god.
I hate myself.
Vivian.
I can't pretend anymore.
What oh jeez.
Vivian, don't.
No. Oh jeez. Holy crap.
Fuck. No. Why'd you have to do that, Vivian? Vivian. Shit.
Damn it.
Vivian, I didn't fucking mean it. I was just... fuck!
Get up. Get up.
Don't think so, Bigby. I'm gonna die here. I think we both know that. Just make sure you give the crooked man the same treatment when you find him.
You betcha.
Really,
damn, that was...
Up for me, all right.
He'll get it worse than you. Why do you care?
For both of us.
He'll get it worse than you.
Worse. Worry.
Good. Old foundry by the river. All right? Shepherd Metalworks. He'll be there. Fucking asshole. You want to finish me off now?
I mean, what do you want?
Or do you plan to kick me around a little first? Rip my limbs off one by one? That's what you want to do, right? Well, whatever it is, just get it over with.
That's not who I am. Not anymore, at least.
No more games, all right? We both know how this ends. Just make it quick.
You sure? Kill him. He's asking for it. I mean, I'm not going to deny him. I mean, he said it. That's gruesome. Oh my god. Holy fuck. Oh my god. Holy shit, man. Damn. I guess they're gonna be ready for me when I get there. So is Crooked Man really the one behind this? Because Bloody Mary said something about shipping metalworks. Let's look at the car. Gonna have to get ready for another action sequence or whatever.
He's here, alright.
Just doesn't make sense to me. Because Bloody Mary said something about the Queen of Hearts a while ago.
Of course.
Oh. Great. I didn't realize he was in the limousine. I really should have taken on the limousine. Too late to go back now. Let's take a look at these boxes.
So this is where you've been sending these.
Let's wipe our hands off first. The controller's getting a bit slippery. Oh, there's... Let's open the door. Well, this is going to be rough. A very rough ending.
Big B Wolf.
That's Bloody Mary, right?
The Big Bad Wolf.
She's just hiding in the shadows or whatever. Or a mirror, perhaps. What is this? Locked up here. A vampire, perhaps? Who knows?
You used to be something.
Yeah, I used to be something. Yeah, now I'm a different something. Who the hell is this? Nope. Oh, someone's been following us. Ooh. That's very odd.
They used to fear you.
I feel like she's gonna try to get me to back up onto that.
They'd hide anywhere their small shivering bodies would fit.
Anywhere, huh? Okay, we gotta go this way. This is very interesting. I haven't done this much walking for a long time. So this is where they've been making... Yeah, I am the Big Bad Wolf. But I'm not so bad anymore. Ooh, she got me!
It's about time you showed up.
Where did she come out of?
I had to take care of some things first.
Little errand boy.
I see you made it here in one piece.
Great.
I do apologize, but I have some business to attend to. I leave you in the capable hands of my associate. Come find me when you finish, dear.
Don't worry. This won't take long.
Get out
Bloody
of my
Mary.
Way. Now.
Why are you being a dick?
It's worse.
Aw, he doesn't want to play.
No, I don't. Cut the shit, I'm talking to you. We're gonna hit her, because we definitely know that she's...
What a man. Stealing punches while my back is turned. Didn't your mother ever teach you to fight proper?
Ha! Ja! How does she disappear? That doesn't explain her power at all. I thought she hides in, like, fucking mirrors. We got one hit on her. One clean hit, and then she fucking disappears. She definitely gonna put us on the fucking wheel, isn't she? Oh, did she transform? Dude, that's cool as fuck, not gonna lie. She went up there, but I'm gonna anticipate over here. So is she, like, super fast, I guess? Well, let's keep moving. I don't think we really... Keep going. I feel like I'm gonna get a jump scare. Ah, fuck me. I didn't press Y fast enough. This is gonna be tough. Aw, man. Keep moving, I guess. I think it's gonna be Y again, but I'm not sure. So I'm just gonna mash all the buttons. Oh. Haha! Haha! I think I'm pressing the buttons right, but I could very well be wrong.
Come out and face me!
Oh yeah? Turn around, Big B, come on. She nasty, yo. Is that what she's supposed to look like? That's so nasty. What is a button? What is a button? Hi-ya! That was terrible timing. She's nasty gross. Oh, we missed our opportunity. She only kicked us, though. I honestly thought I ducked down. Get off. We landed on her, I guess? I don't know what happened there. I hope she doesn't break my arm again. That would suck. You gotta believe. There she is again. Ah, that's such a nasty sound. Ah. Every time she breathes. Whoa. How the fuck? What? What are we supposed to do now then? Go all out? I don't know. Which one's the real one? Or are they all real? I don't know. We'll go for the first one, I guess. Go for the next one. Okay. Okay. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to be doing here. I'm not sure. Yeah. Go for it, I guess. So I guess they're all technically real then. Oh jeez. Oh, what the fuck is? Come on, we gotta survive this. We got it. We're Bigby. Oh shit. So that wasn't our final form. Dang, son. Get wrecked. Get wrecked. Oh, gross. Fuck her up. Broken. So much glass and shit. And nonsense. Oh, jeez. She coming after us. Oh, there's another one. Come on. Cha-cha-cha-cha-cha. Get wrecked. Who else are we gonna wreck? Can she just make an infinite amount of people? Oh, jeez. Her power can't hold up forever, right? Call me. Oh, I'll huff and I'll puff and I'll blow your house down. Ha! Huh, cool. That's pretty cool, not gonna lie. So which one's the real one? I guess that one, maybe? Taking this bitch out, and then we're taking on the Crooked Man, because he's a dumb fuck. She pulled out a shard? She's gonna attack me with it. That's gross, man. Go for it. She's gonna stab me in the eye? Oh, we got her before that happened, I guess? Was she a fake, or was that the real one? I think that was the real one. We got pretty fucked up out of that. Damn, dude. Are we good? Are we cool? Get yourself together, Big B. Where the fuck are we finding all of this clothes? There's the Crooked Man. We took out his strong person. Now let's talk, you piece of shit.
Hello, Bigby. You look tired.
Oh,
give
no.
Me one good never better. To rip you apart right now.
Cuz he's got a silver bullet.
Six rounds of specially designed silver bullets.
Ship.
I won't miss next time. Before you do anything with me, I thought I should point out a few things. Snow White wants you to bring me back to the woodlands, doesn't she?
Yeah, she does.
What I want.
Don't be so sure
about that.
Yes, I'm quite sure. You will bring me back alive. Look, all I ask for is the chance to speak for myself in front of the community. And I'm sure Miss White would agree that I should be given a fair trial.
Ooh.
Can we at least agree on that?
Why would you want that?
The whole town will be calling for your execution. Why would you want me to bring you back there?
Why don't you let me worry about that?
He's probably going to pay some people off.
There's no reason for us to be at each other's throats here.
That's funny. Coming from a guy pointing a gun at my head.
This is just a precaution. I'm sure you understand.
And it doesn't seem like much of a precaution.
Wolf. I didn't kill those women.
Yeah, but you told someone else to. That.
All I'm asking for is a chance to explain my side of the story.
I believe Georgie.
I didn't carry it out. But I don't think Georgie was lying when he said you ordered their deaths.
Georgie would have said anything to save himself. We both know that.
Yeah, I still killed him.
I'm a businessman, not a killer.
There's still a lot you have to answer for.
And I will, as long as you agree to my terms. Because I'm not saying another word until I'm brought before the community.
You need to say another word right now, or I'm not letting you...
be unreasonable. If you decide to do something stupid, like murder me, you won't get your answers. But you will have a difficult time explaining yourself to Miss White and the rest of this miserable town.
He's backing up. Why are you backing up?
You're often reckless, and I worry you're not thinking of the... Let me ask you an honest question. What do you really care about here? Where this case is concerned.
It's about faith, it's about Fable Town, dude.
Protecting Fable Town. Some asshole murders two of our people. It's my job to bring them down.
Then why are you here? You know who murdered them.
I already took him down, and he says you're the one who told him to.
He's dead, isn't he? My point being, the killer has been dealt with. You've won.
No.
You really think I'm that stupid?
I understand you have an obligation to bring me in, but you can brighten up a little. It's over.
I don't know.
So, shall we get going? I'd rather not do all
that. Fuck, can we pause? We can pause. Shit. I know you guys are gonna see whatever decision I make, but maybe leave a comment down below saying what you would do. Let's get back to this. I don't want to let him go, but I'm gonna do against my better judgment.
Hand over the gun.
I think I'd rather hold on to it, if you don't mind.
No, I do mind.
What do you say?
I'm taking the gun. I want to take the gun. I'm taking the gun.
I'm sure Miss White will be pleased. Such a reliable pup. I understand why she'd want to keep you around.
I'm gonna hit him, and then I'm gonna cuff him. Don't give me shit. Oh, we fucked
You're
up his nose.
Arrest. You'll be given a trial in front of your peers. And your punishment will follow.
We caught the crooked man, but at what cost? This was way too early for the episode. My last cigarette is the achievement we just unlocked. Very interesting.
I know.
Witching Well Chamber, the Woodland Building,
early
morning time.
Are we sure he's coming?
Yes, you'll have an opportunity to... He's back.
The crooked man.
Thank God.
Motherfucker.
Are you okay?
Oh, hell no. He didn't make it easy. Don't I look okay? He didn't make it easy.
No, he didn't make it easy.
What happened?
Oh, you really want the play-by-play?
We can talk about it later. You did well, Sheriff. I'm surprised. Not that you did well, but that, you know...
That I didn't kill him?
I'm just glad you made it back in one piece.
It's about time you showed up. Now throw this asshole down the fucking well.
Yes, what are you waiting for?
You killed Lily.
She was my sister.
How could you? What do you have to say for
yourself?
Where
the fuck do you get off? You think you have the right to just do this to people? You're a fucking crook.
You should be ashamed.
Shithole.
Everyone, can I have your attention? Thank you all for coming here on such short notice. I know normally we'd schedule a formal hearing, but considering the circumstances, I thought it best if we do this as soon as possible. The Crooked Man is charged with the murder
as
of Faith
and... As I already informed your sheriff, it was Mr. Georgie Porgy who killed those women, not me.
What? It was Georgie?
Georgie.
I don't mean to interrupt you, Miss White.
You gave the order, bro.
Georgie killed them, but you made the call.
Do I have to explain the situation to you again?
Wait a minute. So you're saying Georgie's the motherfucker who killed my sister? Well, where is he?
Yeah, you're gonna bring that shithead in too, aren't you?
Yes, Sheriff. Where is the rotten scoundrel now?
Is he still out there?
I sincerely hope not. Well, where is he?
He wasn't
Sheriff?
Behind it.
Georgie was a victim of this psycho, too. He was pushed into the whole thing, and now he's dead.
He's what?
Dead.
So yeah, he attacked me, so I put a knife in his stomach.
No
that doesn't change
this.
Anything. We'll deal with it later, but right now, you're the one I'm concerned with.
You called the shots. Georgie made that perfectly clear.
In which case, you still have a lot to answer for. And I was told
I would be allowed to speak.
We have to read the rest of the charges.
What other charges?
If you wait a moment...
Fine, go ahead. How about I kill you instead, you piece of shit?
How about I go ahead and kill you right now?
In front of all these people?
Yeah, I could.
Like I give a shit.
After the rest of your crimes are read through, then you will have an opportunity to defend yourself, but only then.
If you insist.
You are charged with the murder of Faith and Lily, which Georgie carried out on your order, inciting violence against various members of the Fabletown community, including the attempted murder of Sheriff Bigby Wolf.
Twice.
A misunderstanding.
Aiding and providing monetary support for the forced prostitution at the Pudding and Pie. Additionally, you are charged with multiple counts of fraud, extortion, racketeering, and the illegal possession and sale of magical artifacts.
Don't interrupt.
Now, is there anything you would like to say?
I should have said a resisting arrest, but it was
first of all,
the bar was going down quickly.
Bullshit! Like hell you
stop
did.
The charade. We know you're involved.
Come on.
You're responsible, dude.
I know you're responsible. You've been behind all of this from the beginning.
Unless
so
you have something else to say.
We all know who you are. We know what you've
just
done.
Just give it up already.
The Crooked Man has committed crimes against this government and, most importantly, its citizens. These charges, if proven, are enough to justify death, upon which your body will be committed to the witching
where it fucking belongs.
That's
so
right.
Let's get
but
on
we
with
promised
it then.
You a chance to defend yourself. And I won't rob you of that right.
What the
you're
fuck?
This is about
talk?
Justice. If we're ever going to pull ourselves together and make something of this town, we have to start doing things correctly.
Yeah,
no more snap judgments, no more secrets. We are going to treat everyone fairly, even when they don't deserve it.
Yeah, man. We
this
shouldn't uncuff him. I don't think we should have uncuffed him. Now, what do you have to say?
You have the floor.
Thank you, Miss White. You've all met Georgie. I don't have to tell you what kind of person he was. He was a total scoundrel, lacking in any sort of moral fiber. I hired him as a favor to his family, you see. A promise kept to a dying mother.
Oh,
are you gonna get to your point or what?
Georgie was working for me, yes. But he was not acting on my behalf when he killed those women. It was his business. And for whatever reason, I'm sure I'm
see, Vivian advocated for Georgie, and that's why
employees.
I believe Georgie.
I had nothing to do with it.
That's not what Georgie said.
Georgie seemed pretty convinced he didn't have a say in the matter.
He clearly misunderstood my intention.
Really?
I would never authorize such an act.
Any of you actually believe this bullshit?
No.
Holly, please.
Tell them, Bigby. When you finally showed up at my door last night, wasn't I more than helpful? I answered your questions. I was willing to cooperate.
I wouldn't call
What's
that help.
What are you talking about?
You weren't being helpful. You were trying to set me up. Your people tried to kill me.
They get a bit carried away sometimes, it's true. Loyal to the end. They do it because they want to protect me. As I protected them?
No.
You understand wanting to protect what you care about, don't you? You'd do anything. You might even give up an innocent man just to save someone.
You better have a point.
What's he talking about?
I really hope you're going somewhere with this.
I see. You want to cut right to the point. I can appreciate that. Let me explain this to you. My employees are just that. Hired help. I see some of them are here among you. They are not my slaves. They are all free to make their own decisions, as Georgie was.
What about Lily? She wasn't free. She wasn't given a choice. Do you really think she wanted... that any of those girls wanted their lives like that?
I'm sorry, Holly. I'm sorry that your sister asked me for help, and I'm sorry that I decided against my better judgment to give her a distasteful job.
Right, and you kept them in debt so they couldn't leave.
Yeah, that's what you did to us. How you kept us all
in line. You forget it was not me who put you in that position. You all act like I'm some kind of tyrant. When your government abandoned you, left you poor and helpless, sniveling on street corners, I was there to look out for you.
Yes, but...
wasn't I?
We didn't abandon anybody. That was Crane, dude.
Crane was the one who let this town go to the fucking dogs. The guy who was in your pocket, remember?
Really?
Yeah, really.
What about Archie Greenleaf? Her story is not uncommon. She left everything she had back in the homelands. Everything that matters, anyway. With nowhere else to turn, she came to me for help. And what did I do for you?
You got my tree back.
I got her tree back. And in turn, we used her magic to help poor Fables get glamours. Because I helped her, she was able to make a living, provide for herself. And what did they do?
For the longest time, not much. But they asked me to come work for them.
Really? The new deputy mayor wants you on the 13th floor?
No. The wolf offered me the job. She wanted my tree destroyed. If she had had her way, I'd be hung out to dry on a clothesline by now.
What?
You were gonna burn her tree? Snow, why would you...
Snow made a mistake.
I know. Snow made a mistake.
I had very good reasons for asking you to do that. She was working with Crane and the Crooked Man.
Yeah, but... but that doesn't mean we have to kill her.
You can lie to yourself, but you can't lie to me. You hated Crane, and you hated him for wanting to fuck you, and you being too soft to notice what he'd do to get it. It had nothing to do with the Crooked Man.
We've made some mistakes.
I just said that.
I've made some mistakes. But believe me, I truly want what's best for this town.
Why do I keep standing by her? I don't like that.
Right away. But I want you all to know that I care deeply about all of you. And so does the sheriff.
I feel like I care more about them.
I can't promise you perfection. No one can. But I can promise to always have your best interests at heart.
We'll do better.
You haven't been great for a while now, but we'll do better at protecting you from people like him.
The Crooked Man's been exploiting you, exploiting your hope for a better life. You would go to him for help, and he would take that weakness and add it to his strength.
We're ending it.
You're not gonna tolerate this shit anymore. The debts are wiped. His business is closed. He's done.
What does Beast have to say?
You're all still afraid of him, even now. But you needn't be. His contamination of this town is over, and those girls will have their justice.
It was quite an emotional debate.
Very good. The sentiment is surely appreciated, Miss White. But it doesn't disguise the fact that these accusations are completely unfounded.
The hell are you talking about?
He doesn't have a particle of evidence linking me to the...
Georgie was working for you. Bigby got a confession that...
A confession that nobody heard. Now, I'm no barrister, but I think such a statement would carry more weight if Bigby weren't the only one to whom Georgie spoke. Especially given Bigby's history.
What are you talking about?
Snow?
You can't talk your way out of this. You
won't be able to talk your way out of this, Crooked Man.
What do you mean there's no evidence?
Maybe he's... I mean, this doesn't feel right, how we're doing this. And just...
Of course it's right. This man tormented all of you for profit. Georgie
Let
killed him.
Let me just make sure I understand you. You're trying to say that I'm responsible for what Georgie did because he was working for me at the time, yes?
No.
Yes.
Where are you going with? Just, no. Where are you going with this? We literally just went...
For Georgie's mistakes, shouldn't Miss White be held accountable for Bigby's actions as well?
Like what?
How about the way he treated poor Tweedledee when he was in your custody?
That was Bluebeard,
was
you idiot!
To mashed apples while under your watch.
Under
that was Bluebeard.
Watch.
Maybe he's right. Did you think we'd all just let that go?
You can't be serious.
That was Bluebeard!
And I needed answers.
Besides, Crane was still deputy mayor when that happened. Right before you decided to kidnap him.
It was for his own protection. Oh, you're right, dear. Crane was in charge. Sometimes it's hard to tell the difference.
That's enough.
So, you won't answer for your employee's behavior, but I must perish for...
Because you told him.
Different.
I did not order those two girls dead. It simply never happened.
What are you talking
Georgie
about?
Killed Faith and Lily. End of story.
He's just
they
trying to talk his way out of it.
For their own tangled ends, but they refuse to answer for their own
this
crimes.
This is right.
Oh, please. This isn't the point.
We'll deal with them after we deal with you. Everyone
calm down.
This isn't I believe a certain level
here.
Of privilege should be afforded to them.
This is how it's always been.
This is what I'm talking about. We lashed our ropes to this diseased world, and ever since, one of us has been there for you. Who filled your lives with the promise of more? Who was there while they idly played in their towers, judging you, treating you as mindless children, too stupid to command your own destiny? Without me, who will pay your rent when you're on the verge of eviction? Who will dare challenge their brutality when it leaks to our dear citizens? Who will protect you from the big bad wolf? Who will be the...
Bigby? Miss White?
Excuse me.
I wanted to make sure I had the chance to say something.
Why don't you take a moment to catch your breath?
What's she doing here?
I'd like to... I need to say something.
Yeah, what's up?
We're kind of in the middle of something.
She has something to say, you don't...
She has something to say, and we're gonna listen. Go right ahead.
You probably don't remember me. I don't know why I was afraid to come
My
here.
Dear, I don't
Just shut up. You enslaved us for years. Let us hear stories about what you do. Told us we would lose everything if we stepped just one toe out of line. And we
Perfect.
Couldn't say a word about it because of these damn ribbons. But you know what? Now it's my turn to talk.
Vivian took off
I
her ribbon.
I found Vivian's body. Did you kill her?
Vivian killed
Did
herself.
He? Sheriff, this is highly irregular.
Vivian killed herself. Back at the pudding and pie.
I'm sorry, I don't think I...
Nerissa! My name is Nerissa.
It's okay, my dear. It's going to be just...
He ordered them dead. This fucker. Faith and Lily...
That's a lie.
I was in the goddamn room when he did it. Faith and Lily are dead because of you. The only two people who ever gave a damn about me.
Don't worry. He's gonna pay for it.
He made Georgie do it. It was always him. Georgie would have never done anything without his say-so. Ever.
You're going to take the word of a...
At least five other girls will back me up on this. We all heard you say it.
Did you now?
Looks like we found our evidence.
She saw it firsthand.
He's guilty.
Good enough for me.
Me too.
I feel like this is
so
ending too soon. There's right? gotta be something
the
else.
Well. Nah, that's too fucking easy for a crook like that.
What do you mean?
He's gotta pay for what he did.
Listen to yourselves.
You're all rats, fleeing from one sinking ship to the next. So quick to latch onto whatever will keep your miserable lives afloat. This is how you want to repay all I've done for you.
What, you take two people's lives away and now you
You're
want
done
mercy?
Talking?
You know we can't let you go free after this.
What did you expect to happen here? You're getting what you deserve.
I can't help but wonder
now,
if,
for
if
sentence,
someone else is behind this.
What are you talking about?
He's guilty. I know that, but we don't have to kill anybody. We can imprison him. Lock him up forever. Somewhere he can never hurt anyone again. How can we be sure he won't escape?
I can help. We'll use magic.
That's
I assure
not good
you.
Enough.
Maybe there will be more if he isn't stopped.
Let's be humane about it. I mean,
you can send
everyone, listen up! Clearly, we're having trouble agreeing on a suitable punishment, so I think
this is going nowhere.
Someone needs to make a decision. Who?
I hope
we should vote.
Suggesting yourself.
You should have a vote. Make it democratic.
Do you really think that's going to work?
He's right. Nobody can agree on anything. What about Bigby? What about him? He was appointed. He's the only official representative, really. He should be the judge.
That makes sense to me.
I guess it does.
Okay. Shit. Fuck.
Are you
sure?
Fuck.
They're gonna hate me.
It's your call.
They gave me the option, so they can't hate me forever.
Do what you think is right.
Lock him up, throw him down the well, rip his head off. Ooh. Let's lock him up. We're gonna lock him up. As much as I hate his guts.
Not this way.
Come! Punch him?
There you are. I hope you all remember this moment. Think of me when you try to sleep.
Lock him up. We decided we were gonna lock him up.
You said you had a way to keep him from hurting people.
Wait, you can't be serious.
What he's done? You're just gonna put him in prison?
This isn't the way, Sheriff. You're doing the right thing.
Yes, there's a way.
I think we got the majority of people backing us up on that. I think we did the right thing, keeping him locked up. Achievement unlocked. The North Wind blows. Oh, man. This is super intense right now. I'm pretty... The Woodland Luxury Apartments. One day later. I swear to goodness gracious, if he gets out and she let him out, I'm gonna be pissed as hell. Is he a crow now?
Not what I was expecting. Morning. Crooked man.
He's got a sharp tongue. I thought it would be better for everyone if he parted with it.
Thanks, Greenleaf.
Work is work, I guess.
Hey, Sheriff. Are you gonna
hey,
come
buddy.
See the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay. Great.
Cool, I guess. I don't know what's going on.
It's
so that's Hans. Hey, it's Hans. There's fucking what's-his-face. Little Tim, all the other people. Great.
Oh, Mr. Wolf, Flycatcher left his keys.
Oh, thanks. Everything okay?
Is everything okay? You look...
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I have to take care of this.
Okay. She's doing her best.
We'll talk later, okay?
Cool.
Good morning, Miss White.
You're late.
So it seems that everything's settled down. But I'm gonna be... Oh, no. Oh, no. Something's in the elevator. Oh, nothing is in the elevator. That camera shot from inside the elevator made me think there's gonna be, like, another dead person. Damn, dude. This has been crazy. Holy shit. That popping sound went away, too, so that's good. Yeah, I guess we'll just make this the finale. He didn't get glamored. What?
Oh, God! Jesus!
We only have like 5 minutes.
They carry me for fact's sake. I don't give a shit.
You forgot these.
Oh, thank you. It's been pretty busy around here.
Holy sheriff.
this fucking day.
Hey, Toad, don't give me this.
Shit! Just go grab that, would you?
Oh, poor TJ.
I tried to help. Just why the hell did she have to send me and me boy away, huh? You promised me I'd get another chance, but Miss White said I had to go up to the damn farm anyway.
I didn't promise anything.
I'm walking, all right? Calm down.
I feel kind of bad about it, but at the same time, it's
wait,
like...
Eh. Sheriff Bigby, I have something.
You know, he was up crying all night, poor kid.
What's going on, buddy?
Can you give this to Miss White, please?
What is it?
Dad
sure.
Says there's no time to say goodbye, so...
Sure.
If you could bring it to her? She
sure,
nice.
Buddy.
Yeah, sure.
I couldn't take them all with me, and she said she liked that one the best.
It's whatever he was collecting, those bugs.
It's a willow Aww. Beetle. That's a big one. They're cool.
She'll love it.
When they're little, they have these pouches that squirt juice at you if you touch them.
I'm sure she'll love it.
She said it was pretty.
Oh, I'm
That's
trying to
everybody.
Be a good guy.
What's it like at the farm? I've heard ogres live there, and they eat people in their sleep sometimes.
God, I hope not.
Do we have to go? I want to stay here.
Well, we don't have a choice anymore.
I'm sorry, buddy.
TJ, but look on the bright side, okay? There's plenty of space to run around, and a nice river nearby, so you can swim all you want.
Even in daytime?
Yeah, dude. Even in daytime.
The Monday scene, yeah. It'll be nice. Come on. It won't be so bad.
Have you been there before?
No.
I don't know.
I'm, some of the animals aren't comfortable around wolves, so you wouldn't know, would you?
I guess not. I guess I wouldn't know.
Goodbye,
TJ. Colin, how you doing? Don't you dare give me shit for what I'm doing. If that's the thing you say, I'm gonna be pissed. Still mad? Sorry. You still mad?
Still mad at me.
Would it change your mind?
No.
You got another one of those?
Yeah, I'll give you a smoke.
I'm gonna smoke for the road.
Hand him your cigarette. Yeah, give him the pack. Be nice about it.
Thanks, Bigby. Always a gentleman, aren't you, Bigby?
Oh, thanks, Colin. Flycatcher.
I
don't understand his hat. Or, like, his myth or whatever.
Okay. If you even can.
I'll try.
Yeah, me too.
Damn, dude, this has been crazy as hell. Aw, they're gonna have to stand in the rain? I mean, they're amphibians, but...
Saying goodbye?
Yeah, dude, I am. Is that Narissa? Narissa's a nice person.
Hi.
Or at least I think she is.
Hi.
She's still wearing that ribbon. I don't know
still
why she's...
wearing that thing.
Oh. Yeah. I guess I am. It's not easy to forget. I know it seems like I should be able to. It's just...
Should I remove the ribbon? I'm gonna try to...
Bigby, I know you're trying to help.
Mm,
this is just something
that's very suspicious.
To do on my own.
That is okay. Very suspicious.
Listen, I came here because I have to tell you something.
What is it?
It's about what happened to Faith and Lily. Not sure where to start. Faith, Lily, and I, we had this plan. We're gonna find a way out. Leave the pudding and pie for good. But then Faith decided to get some leverage. She stole a picture of Crane and Lily together. The minute Faith stole that photo, we had dirt on one of the Crooked Man's allies. If he found out, I had no choice. You have to understand.
I don't know what you're
talking
about. You've
seen how they kept us quiet in that place. Can you imagine the length
just tell me.
Just to silence someone who had physical evidence?
Narissa, just tell me what happened.
I freaked out, okay?
Did she
I thought
kill?
If I came clean to Georgie, he'd get the Crooked Man to leave us alone. We could just forget the whole thing. Maybe try again in a few years.
You what?
So told him everything. And I begged for mercy for all of us. I didn't want anyone to die over a picture.
Georgie didn't do mercy.
You were just trying to protect them.
Yeah. Georgie promised he'd smooth things over with the crooked man. But then... Oh, God.
Give her a cigarette.
Here.
Oh, we have more than one pack.
Thank you. I don't know what happened, but that night at the club, Georgie came back and told me things had changed. He had to make an example of us. We had committed treason. And while the two of us were sitting there, as he was telling me this, Faith walked in, and I had to watch while Georgie...
Wait, so Georgie told you all this, not the crooked man? Back at the well, you said...
I know what I said.
But it wasn't the truth, was it?
What does it matter? I know the crooked man did it. So what if it wasn't the whole truth?
Shouldn't have lied.
That makes it okay to lie.
I know he ordered their deaths. I wasn't gonna let him get away with it because of a stupid technicality. Especially after...
But you're still wearing the ribbon, and that makes me
that
suspicious.
Night after Faith, I tried to warn Lily, but she wasn't with her scheduled appointment. So I did the only thing I could do. I left Faith's head at your doorstep. I walked her over here, and I left her.
That piece of fabric so I wouldn't notice?
I couldn't save them.
So, that piece of fabric I found near there, that was you?
Yeah. I cut my leg trying to get over the fence.
So you started all this?
I just pointed you in the right direction. People like us get forgotten all the time. The crooked man was counting on that. When we suffer, we do it in silence. And the world likes it that way.
Damn, we dude, this is pretty hefty.
Fade. Like we never existed. I couldn't watch that happen to Faith. Or Lily. Nobody cares about us.
That won't
it's
happen
going
anymore.
To be different now, I promise. Things like that won't happen anymore. Not while I'm around.
I really wonder how big the community right. is.
You and Snow.
I don't know.
Snow seems like...
What I do, it's just not enough for her, or anyone. I just can't win with these people.
I know it might feel that way, but they need you, Bigby. Both of you.
Oh man, I feel like there's still more to do, but at the same time...
The way you look out for each other, and look out for us. You don't see that a lot these days.
We'll stay silent.
Look, Bigby. After everything you've done for us... Maybe they don't want to admit it, but without you, none of this would have happened. You listened when no one else would. You knew when to show mercy, and you brought justice
ears.
To this town.
I mean, we didn't kill the crooked man, so
because
I don't feel terrible
in,
about it, but...
Everyone saw who he really was. So from where I'm standing, you did the right thing. You've been given this job for a reason. And I left Faith at your doorstep.
I hope I've done something good. None of it matters. I've made a lot of mistakes.
I've been making a lot of mistakes lately.
But you've also done a lot of good. Don't forget that. You've changed this place. For better or worse, Fabletown wouldn't be the same without you.
It's not so reassuring when you say you're for better or for worse. But sure, thanks. Thanks for that thought. Don't get yourself killed.
You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
Aww. That's so sweet.
I need to tell you something. I have to tell you something.
I feel like we've met before.
You're trying to place me. You like my ribbon? Do you like it?
Faith Moreland, too, would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom.
They used to call me the Little Mermaid.
Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
They said he wanted to run more tests. I hope you find what you're looking for.
Who the fuck is she? Go after her? Who the
I'll
fuck is she? That's the end. Who the fuck was she? Narissa? Who the fuck? Oh, okay. Let's read this. What did Georgie do? Or what did you do to Georgie? You and 68.6% of players killed Georgie. So we gave him a fast death. Did you give the Crooked Man a trial? You and 89.6% of players brought the Crooked Man back alive. How did you punish the Crooked Man? You and 47.4% of the players chose to imprison the Crooked Man. Did you accept TJ's gift for Snow? You and 98.5% of players decided to accept TJ's gift for Snow. You and 29% of players said, I've made a lot of mistakes, as our last words to Narissa. And that was it. Holy shit. Special stats. Beast, you lied to him about seeing Beauty outside the apartment. Bluebeard, you fought him after the interrogation. Butcher, you offered him protection at the business office. Colin, you gave him a drink when he asked for one in your apartment. You sent Colin to the farm. Crooked Man, you took him back to the witching well and imprisoned him. Greenleaf, you offered her a job. For Gren, you drank with Gren after Lily's funeral. Narissa, you gave her a cigarette during your final conversation. You tried to take her ribbon during your final conversation. Who is she? Her name is Narissa, but what fable is she? Is she supposed to be Little Red? I don't understand. Snow, you brought her along with you to the trip trap. You showed her Crane's photograph of her. Tim-Tim, you chose to wait for him. TJ, you accepted his beetle and promised to give it to Snow. Toad, you slapped him during the interrogation in his apartment. You stood up for him when Snow wanted to send him to the farm. It's not going to be any sort of epilogue, is there? Well, fuck me. I'm actually going to try to look up what was going on with... Well, we'll keep this going. Continue this story. Pick up a graphic novel today. Oh shit, this was a game made out of the comics? There's comics of this. That's awesome. But who is Narissa to Bigby? Continue. I clicked continue, but I'm not sure what's going on. Looks like it cut out or something. Okay, let's bring up this and we're gonna look up who is Narissa. Come on. It's not responding. That ain't good. That ain't good. Come on. It won't let me type. It'll let me open it. Can I close it? Yes. Okay, we gotta find this out. Come on. I don't know what's going on with the game right now. Game's messing something up. The CPU's at 29%. The disk is at 100%. So I'm not exactly sure what's going on. Looks like things are just kind of slowing down real quick. Wow, that was an hour and 13 minutes. There's a lot of stuff to just finish up. Come on. I'll use my phone. I'm going to look this up right now. I can't handle not knowing who she is. Compared or in relation to Bigby. Okay, close out like several tabs. Who? It's not working. Oh, there we go. Is Narissa to Bigby? Who is Narissa and Bigby? Who is Narissa to Bigby? The cryptic finale to The Wolf Among Us explained, because I feel I can't handle this kind of nonsense of closure, you know? Alright, so I'm just going to like try to read the entire article. The internet's two best guesses, and one crazy one. So, Developer Telltale Games, episodic series. He had one more conversation with Nerissa, who had been leading him through the investigation throughout the series. As she turns to leave, she says, "You're not as bad as everyone says you are." And this triggers a usual suspect-style realization montage as our hero makes a series of connections between his information and Faith, the woman whose death all the way back in the first episode set him on his path for the rest of the series. See, Faith said exactly the same thing at the end of her conversation with Bigby and Faith. And this has fans wondering if the whole case was even more complicated than they thought. Specifically, that Faith and Nerissa are the same person at some point. Here's what they've come up with. 1. Nerissa was Faith. There's a theory that says Nerissa was Faith. Before we get into specifics, here's a reminder on one of the Wolf Among Us most confusion-inducing plot elements, glamours. These are spells that let fables appear in different forms. Featured heavily throughout the series, Fable Town law requires all non-humanoid residents to buy some magic so that the outside world doesn't notice all the giant toads. One thing I wanted to say about that is that the people who don't have to get the magic should pay like some sort of tax to make it cheaper. Because that's just totally unfair to make them pay for it outright. If everybody could pay some taxes so the whole community could be together, that'd be very awesome. So back to this. Glamours make things complicated because you're never really sure who is who. And when Big Me and everyone else really mistakes Holly's body for Snow White's because it was all magicked up. So this theory claims Nerissa we'd been taking the entire time was actually Faith using a glamour to look like the ex-Little Mermaid. What does this mean, though? It means that Faith doesn't die in episode 1. Nerissa does. In this case, we have an extra crazy making double glamour station in which Georgie means to murder Faith, but accidentally kills Nerissa instead because she's been under the enchantment, possibly because she was covering one of Faith's work shifts at the strip club. And then the real Faith has to disguise herself as the now-dead Nerissa to cover up her tracks, keep her from getting murdered herself. Holy crap. Citing Dr. Swinehart needs to run additional tests on the remains and the magic mirror's inability to locate Faith as evidence. Yeah! Holy crap, that's a very interesting point. Okay, so what's the other theory? Theory 2, Faith was Nerissa. This version of events says that Faith we meet at the beginning isn't her at all. In fact, it's Nerissa under a glamour in an attempt to call Bigby's attention to nefarious dealings going on below Fable Town's already pretty shady surface. What does this mean? In this case, Faith is already dead at the beginning of the game, and Nerissa as Faith intentionally starts trouble with the woodsman so that Bigby would show up and start snooping around. She had to disguise herself as the dead woman so that he'd make the connection when he found the... Okay. Interesting. For this reading, Faith, the title character of the first chapter, and the person from whom all of Bigby's motivation springs, never appears alive the entire game. Also makes a little more sense considering the fact that Nerissa intentionally gives herself away at the end. If Nerissa is really Faith in disguise, as the first reading says, how much sense does it make to leave Bigby with that loose thread? She's only opening herself up to a bunch of questions from an annoyed werewolf. Meanwhile, if Faith was Nerissa telling Big B about it, it doesn't change anything. She was just leading him along the investigation for slightly longer than he thought. Anyway, okay, so which one is real? If you want to read some good discussions of this hypothesis and a bonus theory that says Nerissa was actually Bloody Mary the whole time, but I don't think anyone lends it that much weight. Okay, so somebody thinks there's three different schools of thought. The first school of thought is that Nerissa was posing as Faith and it got kind of mixed up, and so Faith took up Nerissa's cover, or something like that. And then the second one was just saying that Faith was Nerissa, and pretty much the same thing. Either way, so the first one says that Faith is still alive, I believe. And then, no, it's the other way around. The first one is saying Nerissa's still alive and Faith died. And then the second one, I think, is saying that Nerissa died and Faith is still alive. I could be wrong and I'm messing this up, but I thought you guys might want some closure with that. I honestly thought initially that at the end he was talking about, or at the end Nerissa was something to do with like Little Red Riding Hood or something, but I guess she's dead and just non-existent in this game. But holy crap, that was quite a train ride, guys. If you have any theories as to who may or may not be Nerissa, or if she's just Nerissa, leave a comment down below telling me your thoughts. I'd really love to hear them. I'd love to have a conversation with some of you guys. I think that'd be pretty awesome. If you guys were entertained by this series and you enjoyed it thoroughly and you were on the emotional roller coaster with me, leave a like for this video, because it means I met my goal of entertaining you and getting you engaged with these games, sparking your interest in something, if that counts for anything. One, I hope you enjoyed this series as much as I enjoyed making it for you. It's been crazy. And, yeah, addressing a few things, suicide is not necessarily the answer in the case of Vivian. I mean, if she was still alive, she might have been there to advocate for us as well instead of Nerissa, but who knows? But in your case, if you're having a trouble spot in your life, do not hesitate to reach out to me. I'd love to talk with you and maybe even collab with you on a few games if you'd be interested. But there's always someone out there looking for you. It is this llama. I just say the whole outro thing because it's catchy, I guess, and it goes with the whole theme of the abominable llama. But I really do care, okay? It's no joke when it comes to things like that. I'm going to step back for a second. I'm going to escape my real persona and switch back into my stage persona. And I'd like to tell you that Nerissa loves you. Whoever the fuck Nerissa is. Snow loves you. Just about every fable we've seen in this game loves you. In this wonderful story, they all love you. But it's just not this llama. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. If you like this video, leave it a like, I guess. I'm repeating myself now, so I'm gonna leave it at that. Buh-bye.